So what a night we've had so far. Big night for the United States. But it could be a very big night for Asia right now, because the very best from Asia is about to go here. No Chinese man has ever won a gold medal at the Olympics, and only one Korean, male or female, has ever won a medal at the Olympics, and both those men are here. I'm talking about Park Tae-won, the gold medalist.
Well, he would be thanking his lucky stars as well for those that missed it. He was disqualified in the heats of the 400 freestyle for leaving early on the blocks. It is a no false start rule here. He protested immediately through his team management here at the pool. That protest was rejected and he remained disqualified. FINA, our governing body internationally, held a very special sitting of 22 FINA Bureau members. They reviewed it and they have allowed Park Tae-won to come into this race. So they have quashed the disqualification for leaving early. So interestingly, he was disqualified for the same thing in 2004.
So here is the lineup. Ryan Napoleon from Australia will go from lane one. He was second in the Commonwealth Games in 2010.
This is a great achievement for Ryan to make the final of the 400 metres freestyle. Trains with Michael Bowl along with seven other Australian Olympic swimmers.
So Gogo Kiss, he's very good at the 800 and 15. We don't have an 800 at the Olympics, but he was a bronze medalist in both those events at the World Championships.
His third Games, and this is his first time in the 400 free final.
He had a good swim this morning. He took his trial swim from 3.47.8 to 3.46.2.
Both the two American boys in this field train with the Florida Gators and Greg Troy, so they're training partners of Ryan Lochte, so they've just watched him win a gold medal.
So Sun Young here, he's the silver medalist in the World Championships, but he's one of three men only to have gone under 3.41, and maybe he's the man to do the world record tonight here.
Coached by Dennis Cottrell at the Miami Queensland Club on the Gold Coast is Sun Young.
Vanderkuy's already got a couple of gold medals in the relays, both from Athens and from Beijing, and he was fourth in this final in Beijing 4 years ago. So Park Tae-won's the man who won in Beijing. He's the world champion. He's a silver medalist also in Beijing in the 200, so he's got all of Korea's medals in swimming.
Yes. The Chinese men are doing exceptionally well. They've really come through to join the Chinese women in terms of accomplishments, but yet to win a gold medal.
Well, he's the youngster, Hao Yun, in this final, just 17 years of age. He's the only teenager out there. And if he's the youngster, he's followed out by the veteran.
David Carey from Great Britain. Improved from the 2008 Olympic Games to make a final. He was 15th in 400 freestyle in 2008, so a big opportunity for him.
So it looks a battle, doesn't it, between China and Korea, and with the two Americans thrown in, do you think, for the minors?
Well, Peter Vanderkuy, it's nice for him. He's in between Sun Yung and Park Tae-won, so that might drag him along very nicely. One thing I know is that Park Tae-won will be very careful on this start. Plenty of time to catch up any deficit on the start, though, over 400.
So the nerves will be jingling a bit for him. Can he defend the championship here? Ian Thorpe did that, of course, in Athens after winning in Sydney. Murray Rose did it a long time ago. In Rome after winning in Melbourne. Americans have had a great run in this, but they haven't won since 84. Can China win its first gold medal, male gold medal at the Olympics? So the 400 freestyle final, they're away from the top. Napoleon, Australia, Kiss Hungary, Dwyer, United States, Sun Young of China, Vanderkuy, United States, Park Tae-won of Korea, Hao Yun of China, and Carey of Great Britain. So it looks like Park Tae-won may be just in front in lane six.
Even after the disqualification this morning, Park Tae-won had the fastest reaction time off the block, so he has not left anything wondering when it came to his start, and they are under world record already.
By a substantial amount, and he leads from Sun Young and from Hao Yun. So it's Asia 1-2-3 after the first 50 metres of the 400 freestyle final.
The 400 freestyle is a great event to really settle into your stroke and have some tactics. The 200 freestyle, there isn't much time, but the 400, there certainly is. The first 100, Park Tae-won has really got into a nice rhythm with his technique.
And again, it's really quick. Look at this, 1 second inside the world record. That world record's 3.40.07, but only three men have got inside 3.41. That was Paul Biedermann, who broke Ian Thorpe's world record by 1/100th of a second. So Park Tae Won here, to his credit, the defending champion, has said to Sun Young, if you want to take the title off me, come and get it. I'm going to put it on the line here.
And that world record was with the suit, so the world records were affected mostly in the back half, final stages of a race. So beautiful technique by Park Tae Won, beautiful streamline underwater, just one butterfly kick. Expect to see Sun Young come back. His 1500 world record time, he came home very nicely in the second half of that 1500, and he's been doing great work on the Gold Coast with Dennis Cottrell in terms of his pacing.
So at the moment's career leading from China, China, and then the United States and the United States. So the favourites are right up there. He'll be so strong, Sun Young, at the end of this back half, but Park Tae Won's probably increased the lead slightly. He's out to 0.3 of a second, and again they're about 0.8 in front of the world record. So it's a blistering pace as we go past halfway.
And he's breathing away at the moment from Sun Young. No, he's had a look at him. So both boys now are looking at each other and really making sure that they're pacing off each other. I feel like Sun Young has a little bit more momentum in this third 100 metres. This is the 100 metres you really need to make a move. And I know Dennis Cottrell, Sun Young's coach, very well. He would have told him, go. At the 300 metre mark, go.
Well, he's closed the gap, hasn't he? It's just three 100s. The 17-year-old doing a great job in lane 7, Ha Yun, and Van der Kuy pushing through hard also of the United States. The move has been made, and the best from China has taken the lead from the best from Korea. So the defending champion now being challenged by Sun Young.
Park Tae Won changing the side that he breathes to make sure he does continue to breathe to Sun Young. So he just had a little bit of a surge there, Park Tae Won, and he still takes the lead, and they're still on the world record pace.
1/100 of a second between them after 300. One of the great finals in the 400 freestyle of all time. It looks like being the fastest ever, and look at this, they are literally stroke for stroke. Though Sun Young slightly in front now, in fact really putting the pressure on. I think Van der Kuy's got through for third place at the moment. This split, let's see how they turn. It looks like it's Sun Young in front, still on world record pace.
Great swim, still on world record pace. You're right, he'll breathe away from Park Tae Won. No, he changes his stroke to see him. He wants to know where he is, and the big kick comes in now, big 6 feet kick.
So China going for its first gold medal from a male point of view. And could we see the first swim ever under 340? It's been a magical mark. That world record is right on it. Park Tae Won will be second. Van der Kuy third. Can he do the world record? It's going to be touch. And it's going to be, yes, go. Not quite. 340.14.
7/100.
A magnificent swim. Park Tae Won, well, he went down fighting. China gets its first Olympic gold medal. From a male point of view, they've got seven with the women, but they've never had one before. And look at this guy. He's going to be one of the big stars in London 2012. What a reaction.
What a fantastic reaction. Well done, Sun Young, Olympic champion, China's first in the swimming pool. What an amazing performance. Congratulations, China. And congratulations to Dennis Cottrell, his Australian coach based on the Gold Coast.
Dennis Cottrell knows what it's like to have an Olympic champion under his wing, doesn't he?
With Grant Hackett, two gold medals, and now this is his third.
Gee, tactically, didn't he do it well? I mean, he set off, when I say set off, the pace was so fast, but he made his move exactly when you said he would.
Yeah, the 300-metre mark was exactly when he was going to go. The technique is just beautiful. They're so relaxed with their hands and their grab of the water. Nice high elbows, not a lot of whitewash around them.
Well, only three men have broken 3:41. Paul Beatham and the world record holder Ian Thorpe, and this man here.
That's fantastic to see that celebration.
20 years of age and from the most populous country in the world, and now the biggest star in swimming, certainly from a male point of view, they've ever had.
He's worked so hard for this. I've been hearing reports of his kind of sets that he's been doing at training and his work ethic. Anything Dennis asked him to do, he did it. He did it without question. And put 110% if you can, 110% into it.
So China get a gold medal here. So close to the world record. Sun Young, 340.14, an Olympic record. Park Tae Won, the gold medalist from 4 years ago, 342.06, great swim. And Peter Van der Kuy, who was fourth 4 years ago, gets third here in 344.69. It was China, Korea, and the USA after the men's 400-metre freestyle final. All men under 350, you'd expect that, but it was so sharp at the top end.